membrane potential is the difference in electrical charge between the inside and outside of the neuron. This is measured using two electrodes. A reference electrode is placed in the extracellular solution. The recording electrode is inserted into the cell body of the neuron. There is more than one way to describe a change in membrane potential. If the membrane potential moves toward zero, that is a depolarization because the membrane is becoming less polarized, meaning there is a smaller difference between the charge on the inside of the cell compared to the outside. This is also referred to as a decrease in membrane potential. This means that when a neuron's membrane potential moves from rest, which is typically around negative 65 millivolts, toward 0 millivolts and becomes more positive, this is a decrease in membrane potential. Since the membrane potential is the difference in electrical charge between the inside and outside of the cell, that difference decreases as the cell's membrane potential moves toward 0 millivolts. If the membrane potential moves away from 0, that is a hyperpolarization, because the membrane is becoming more polarized. This is also referred to as an increase in membrane potential. At rest, ions are not equally distributed across the membrane. This distribution of ions and other charged molecules leads to the inside of the cell having a more negative charge compared to the outside of the cell. A closer look shows that sodium, calcium, and chloride are concentrated outside of the cell membrane in the extracellular solution, whereas potassium and negatively charged molecules like amino acids and proteins are concentrated inside in the intracellular solution. This ion distribution leads to a negative resting membrane potential. These ion and concentration differences lead to varying degrees of electrochemical gradients in different directions depending on the ion in question. For example, the electrochemical gradients for sodium and potassium drive ion flow in different directions. If the membrane is permeable to sodium, ions will flow inward. If the membrane is permeable to potassium, ions will flow outward. The neuron's membrane potential at which the electrical and concentration gradients for a given ion balance out is called the ion's equilibrium potential. Let's look at sodium in more detail. When sodium channels open, the neuron's membrane becomes permeable to sodium, and sodium will begin to flow across the membrane. The direction is dependent upon the electrochemical gradients. The concentration of sodium in the extracellular solution is about 10 times higher than the intracellular solution, so there's a concentration gradient driving sodium into the cell. Additionally, at rest, the inside of the neuron is more negative than the outside, so there is also an electrical gradient driving sodium into the cell. As sodium moves into the cell, though, these gradients change in driving strength. As the neuron's membrane potential becomes positive, the electrical gradient no longer works to drive sodium into the cell. Eventually, the concentration gradient driving sodium into the neuron and the electrical gradient driving sodium out of the neuron balance with equal and opposite strengths, and sodium is at equilibrium. The membrane potential of the neuron at which equilibrium occurs is called the equilibrium potential of an ion, which, for sodium, is approximately positive 60 millivolts. The gradients acting on the ion will always drive the ion towards equilibrium. The equilibrium potential of an ion is calculated using the Nernst equation. The constant 61 is calculated using values such as the universal gas constant and temperature of mammalian cells. Z is the charge of the ion being used, and the intracellular and extracellular concentration values for that ion must be known. For sodium, Z, the charge of the ion, is 1. The extracellular concentration is 145 millimolar, and the intracellular concentration is 15 millimolar. This calculates an equilibrium potential of 60 millivolts. It is possible to predict which way an ion will move by comparing the ion's equilibrium potential to the neuron's membrane potential. Let's assume we have a cell with a resting membrane potential of negative 70 millivolts. Sodium's equilibrium potential is positive 60 millivolts. Therefore, to reach equilibrium, sodium will need to enter the cell, bringing in positive charge. On the other hand, chloride's equilibrium potential is negative 65 millivolts. Since chloride is a negative ion, it will need to leave the cell in order to make the cell's membrane potential more positive to move from negative 70 millivolts to negative 65 millivolts.